Huh. Hold on. Are we back? Can you hear me? Can you see the game? Okay. I don't know what the fuck happened. It literally, like, crashed. It's like the freaking screen that was recording just disappeared. And it just fucking crashed. That's a new one. But it's okay. We're fine. I don't even know why it did that. I have no fucking clue. It's like literally the program closed on its own and I had to bring it back. That was weird. That was weird. Thunderbolt. Because you're flying. Yeah. Get down, boy. We're gonna have to heal up Roscoe. And don't worry, I'll deal with the streams and everything when I end. Because I know for a fact I'm gonna have to put like a 0.5 or whatever in the title. Come out and play, little mouse. Okay. Yeah, sorry about that, guys. Okay, ditto. Oh boy. Yeah, transform into that. There we go. Yeah, we'll do this one. Fuck yeah, let's go. Crash, come back. Jonty, come back. Talk to me. Jonty probably has an ad. Because he's not subscribed, so Jonty's probably gonna have an ad or something. That sucks. Slowpoke. We're gonna switch though, but I'm just doing that just for the experience there. Roscoe. Yay, Chris is back, yay. Basically, action crashed without me knowing. And I literally had to reopen it and come back. That's never happened before too. That's kind of weird. Yay, Hyperfang. Fuck yeah. Alright, Murderfly has gone to 31, so Murderfly is going to be turning into a Metapod. Alright. Murderfly, let's go. I'm going to drink more of my drink, too. This drink's really good, man. I still think out of all the Kakuna Pokemon, I like Kakuna the most. Kakuna looks so fucking badass. You just bumped me. I'll bump you back, bitch. You bitch. Nidoking. Rah, 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 rah. Alright. Bring out Roscoe. Now, the reason why I'm not using Mystico right now is I do actually need to work on my other Pokemon. I really do. Hyperfang. Okay, that didn't do a lot. Oh no, because he's normal. It might take him out. Potion it up. Thank you, Jonty, for your contribution. It's okay. Push through. Push through. Come on, little buddy. Oh, you're fine. Rumble does that all the fucking time. Alright. Stunner. I'd like to see you try those normal attacks now. Try that on for size. Of course the poison sting's gonna work. And he's... Oh my god, really? That much small-ass damage, and he got poisoned. Oh, I fucking hate that shit. I really do. I really fucking hate that. Yeah, you can't do that, buddy. Get out of here with that shit. I ain't having that shit. Let's go. Roscoe. Alright. We need to recover Roscoe. Does that hurt? And then we're going to give a full heal to your boy. Full heal. Shaw. Roscoe. Just so Vulpix's attacks don't hurt. Me too. I always loved when Brock got the Vulpix and Pokemon anime too. Just wish he kept it. He never did keep the Vulpix. He ended up giving it back to the actual trainer. So quick attack and roar so far. So, let me give my two cents on the anime. The anime was okay, but there was one thing that ruined the anime for me. And that was Ash Ketchum. I do not like Ash. I am an Ash hater. I don't like him. I'm never gonna like Ash. I don't even like the new version of Ash. Even though they fixed a lot of his attitude. Oh my god, this rant again. So I've ranted about this numerous times. I'm going to talk about it. I'm going to stop right here and I'm just going to lay on my back here with my eyes closed. I'm not even going to look at chat. Yeah, I'm just going to talk about it. Ash is so stupid. He has done some of the stupidest freaking decisions in any Pokemon trainer's life. And also, a lot of the Pokemon that he quote-unquote let go could have helped him in the Pokemon League. Also, half of the badges that he got, he does not deserve them. He just doesn't deserve them. And some of the gym leaders kind of frustrate me. So first off, I'm gonna just put it all on the freaking table. I'm putting it all on the table here. So first off, we're gonna talk about when he fought Brock. For one, I do give Brock some minus points here. Who the fuck puts a sprinkler system in a rock gym? Rock and ground, by the way. Second of all, it doesn't matter if an Onix is completely covered in water. A Pikachu should still not be able to do any damage whatsoever to an Onix. You know why? Because in gaming logic, if you have Rain Dance going on and you use an electrical attack on Onix, guess what? it still does no fucking damage whatsoever. So, automatically, that's fucking stupid. Does he deserve that badge? No, he does not. So, we're going to mark that badge off of his list, too. When it comes to Misty, I feel like Misty went easy on Ash just so he could have got the Cerulean City badge. Okay. The game mind, I'm not looking at chat right now. I just got my eyes closed and I'm just telling you what's going on. So, I feel like Misty went easy on Ash because also she's friends with Pikachu. So, there's that. Now, if Ash would have fought the other sisters of the Cerulean Gym, they would have completely wiped the floor with him. Because especially the fact that they have a seal. When it comes to seal, no matter if it's early level seal or mid level seal, seal has attacks that could have whooped Ash's punk little ass. So automatically, does he deserve the Cerulean badge? No. The Thunder badge. Okay. So Surge is one of my favorite, not only gym leaders, but that's also one of my only episodes that I like. Why? Because Ash got his ass whooped and he finally got to learn a lesson. Okay? He finally got to learn a fucking lesson about that damn Pikachu of his. Okay? Because first off, I'm going to tell you this. Pikachu is completely overrated when it comes to Pokemon. It's like you even ask a person who's not a Pokemon fan, tell them to name one thing that they know about Pokemon. The first thing they're going to say is Pikachu. That's all it's going to be. You know why? Because Pikachu's the fucking mascot. Originally, Clefairy was supposed to be the mascot. Clefairy was going to be Ash's Pokemon. Of course, they changed it because Clefairy's pink. And usually, back in that time frame, pink went more toward the female aspect. But back to Lieutenant Surge. Lieutenant Surge whooped Ash's ass. The only reason that Surge lost was because of the simple fact that he evolved his Raichu too early. He only had Mega Punch and Mega Kick. I believe he only had Thunder Shock as well. But Pikachu was able to have Agility, Double Team, and was able to slam the hell out of that Raichu. So does he gain the Thunder Badge? Sure. When it comes to Erica, you know, I believe the only reason that she would not allow Ash to fight her at first was because of some fucking perfume. First off, this is also coming from somebody who, when he was a little kid, wanted to be a gym leader. Yes, I wanted to be a gym leader when I was a little kid. Fuck off if you want to fucking crucify me over a stupid little kid dream of mine. But I used to also have the official Pokemon Gym Leader's Handbook. Yes, that it was actually a thing back in the day. Don't know if it is a thing now, but it was a thing back when I was a kid. And one of the rules was you had to take any challenger that would come to your gym. Of course, they would have to abide by the challenge given to the gym leader to be deemed as worthy. However, you are not allowed to turn your back on a trainer if they are to want to challenge you for your badge. You are employed by the Pokemon League and given a job. That job being defend your gym, defend your badge, and take in any challengers, no matter their male, female, or anything like that. Okay? And she automatically will not let Ash fight in her gym because of perfume. Fuck off. Now also, did Ash really deserve that badge? Not really. Because he made some stupid fucking decisions in that battle. So let's see. Next, Sabrina. He had to rely on Hunter to actually, quote-unquote, win against Sabrina. In Pokemon League registration rules, the trainer has to technically own the Pokemon to be able to use that Pokemon in battles and a gym. Did Hunter belong to Ash? No.
Hunter just went along with Ash. Now, I guess you could also say, well, what's that make Pikachu? Well, keep in mind, when Ash met Pikachu, Pikachu had an official Pokeball that he came out of when he met Professor Oak. So the fact that Pikachu doesn't use a Pokeball in terms of travel, that's because Pikachu doesn't like a Pokeball. But the thing is, he started off in a Pokeball. So he is a legal Pokemon of Ash's. In terms of Hunter, Hunter was not put in a Pokeball that was designated to Ash. So the Hunter was not part of that whatsoever. Does he deserve the badge? No. Next, Blaine. Blaine is literally my favorite Gen 1 trainer. Second being Sabrina, but only in the Pokemon games. When it comes to Blaine, I love Blaine. I love his Pokemon challenge before even fighting him, where he does the fucking quizzes. I fucking love it. Does he deserve that the badge for that? Sure. Charizard won it for him, though. That's the only thing I can say. Charizard won that shit. Because also, in the first part of that, who the hell puts a Pikachu in a fight against Magmar? We're just going to say that. So automatically, you know, so far, he has gotten the Thunder Badge. You could kind of argue upon the Rainbow Badge and then the Fire Badge, okay? So that's three badges. We'll give him three badges, okay? Next, and technically final, Viridian City Gym. Now, first off, Viridian City Gym is owned by Giovanni of Team Rocket. That is given. If you don't know that, you need to go read up on your fucking Pokemon history, because that's what it is. When it came to Viridian City Gym and Ash going to back to Viridian City to fight the Viridian City Gym, Gary was the only one that fought the actual legit gym leader. And sadly, he lost. If you haven't seen Pokemon the first movie, go watch the beginning of it. It automatically shows you that shit, and it is considered canon. Because of the events of what happened with the Mewtwo movie, is the reason why Giovanni did not fight Ash when it came to getting his last badge. Now, does he technically earn the badge? Not exactly. Let me explain why. Keep in mind, he is the owner of that gym. It doesn't matter if he is part of Team Rocket. He owns the gym. Only him. Only him. It wouldn't even matter if he had some of the Rockets as like gym trainers. He specifically owns that gym. Cool. Okay? Are you feeling me so far? I'm not reading chat yet, but hopefully you guys in chat are feeling me so far here, okay? So, because Giovanni was not the legit gym leader in that situation, but yet he gave, you know, permission for Jesse and James to be part of that, part of the whole gym situation. Technically, he wasn't allowed to do that. Now, I'm going to tell you why, okay? Because then you're going to probably think, okay, what about the whole thing with Fuchsia City? Now, keep in mind, I haven't brought up Fuchsia City, but I'm going to explain it last. All right, I'm going to explain it last. There's a difference between giving somebody unauthorized permission to have legit power over a badge versus someone in your family being given permission to use the gym and official usage of the badge. Giovanni is the sole person in charge of Viridian City Gym. No matter if he's part of Team Rocket or not. Even though Ash beat Jesse and James at Viridian City Gym to get the Viridian City badge, it was not technically considered official because he did not have it with that particular gym leader that is listed on the paperwork. Just keep in mind, to own a gym, You have to have, one, permission from the Pokemon League to actually be an official gym. And B, of course, you're going to have to pass particular tests to be deemed, you know, usable to be used for a gym. Of course, that's freaking common sense. Okay? So, does Ash deserve the Viridian City badge? No, because he did not fight Giovanni, which is the person who was in charge of that gym. So that's another badge that Ash doesn't deserve. Now, Fuchsia City. First off, let me get some of my drink here because my throat is getting dry now. Okay. All right, next. And last, Fuchsia City. Koga is the actual gym leader of that gym. But I believe it was his daughter or his niece that he put in charge of the gym because she is considered family. And of course, he was passing the gym along to her because, of course, Koga ends up becoming an Elite Four. He ends up becoming an Elite Four for Gen 2. One of the best Elite Four, I gotta say. So the fact that, yes, he fought Koga, but he also fought Janine. That was kind of your way of knowing that he was passing the mantle to Janine so he could go and do the Elite Four in Johto. That was also a really, really good match. So does Ash deserve that badge? Sure. We will give him that badge. Because keep in mind what I said here. Now I'm looking at chat, okay? So keep in mind what I'm saying here, okay? Is that there's a difference between giving unofficial permission to use somebody's gym, but then there's passing it to the next generation of bloodline. Because Koga is related to Janine, it was considered official. So in conclusion, Ash Ketchum is dumb. He doesn't deserve a lot of his badges. He let a lot of the wrong Pokemon go. I understand it was for, you know, the whole love of his Pokemon kind of thing. But also at the same time, instead of him letting Pokemon go, he could have worked on his relationship with Charizard. And if he would have worked on his relationship with Charizard, he could have won the Pokemon League. Because it was Charizard that made him lose. I remember it very well. It was Charizard versus Pikachu, Richie's Pikachu. And that Pikachu wrecked Charizard. And also, if you know your Pokemon logic, why would a Pokemon that's considered not yours technically not listen to you? Because you don't have enough badges. Because of course people are like, oh, you know, that's a big hole in a theory. You know, it's like Ash had all of his badges. Why wasn't Charizard listening to him? Because A, Charizard technically did not belong to him. He saved Charmander from an abusive trainer. And Charmander, of course, became friends with, you know, Ash and everything. And as Charmander kept evolving, he was getting more mature. And of course, if a Pokemon that doesn't specifically belong to you at first, you know, evolves and you don't have the right badges, it will not listen to you. That is traded Pokemon logic. It is canon. So why did Ash not, why did the Charmeleon and Charizard not listen to Ash at first? Because he didn't technically own the right type of badges. There's my point. And I'm sticking to it. Now we're getting back to the game. Okay. All right, let's do this. So there's my point. There's my whole rant. I'm sticking to the rant. There you go. I know. It was a rant, but it had to be done. It had to be done. Yeah, don't... See, you can kind of tell now, Pokemon is my forte. Old school Pokemon is my forte. Do not argue with me when it comes to Pokemon, because I'll give you like a 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10 times, you will not win. You will not win it with me.
because I've watched the whole fucking series. I may make a mistake here and there because I am only human and I don't remember everything. But at the same time, fuck Ash Ketchum. Fuck Ash. That's why when they did the whole Pokemon Origins thing with Pokemon Red, and they, you know, of course, like, brought in Mega Evolving and stuff. Oh, that was great. That was fucking great. I love that shit. Alright, let's see. Send to dig. Oh, my voice hurts from that whole freaking rant. Oh my gosh. Jeez. But yeah, that rant was just for you, Jonty. Don't say I don't love you. Don't say I never did nothing for you, homeboy. That was for you. All this shh. Okay. Murderfly. Let's see. Roscoe. Let's go, Mr. Rat. I love how him and fucking Metapod are the same fucking level. Yet we know which one's the strongest right now. This is hilarious. Yay. Don't hit me with that shit, cause I don't want it. Here we go. Hell, still to this day, we don't even know why Brock and Professor Ivy wasn't working out. My bestie thinks that Brock found out that Professor Ivy possibly had a penis. And that probably, like, you know, scared the crap out of him. And the funny thing is, it would kind of make sense if you think about it. Because, you know, Brock had, like, the hots for her and everything, and he stayed with Professor Ivy because he really wanted her. And then later on down the road, it's like when you bring up Professor Ivy, he gets completely fucking triggered. My bestie was like, I bet you when he was going to have his first ever sexual experience with her, he found out she had a giant dong. Oh, really? I mean, I don't mind, you know, women with men parts and stuff. I have my own thoughts about that. But not sharing that on stream. We're talking about Pokemon. We're not talking about that. But yeah, it... Well, keep in mind also, just the way Brock is, you know, Brock's like addicted to women, you know? It's like, if you think about it, I bet you'd probably make sense. It's like, I mean, like, let's see, you know, let's really think about this here. Brock was so addicted to Nurse Joy, Officer Jenny, and any good-looking woman, okay? So we automatically know what type of stuff that Brock is kind of into, okay? So let's try and think of something stereotypical or basic around that time frame of the show that would trigger a male. Let's say, you know, you're so in love with this woman. And you're like, man, I want to spend the rest of my life with her. What's the number one thing you could think of that every time when someone says that person's name, you get triggered? And I'm not talking about, like, triggered as in like the way I get when I rant. I'm talking about deep, dark place triggered. You would think she'd have a scat thing. Oh, I mean, I don't know, man. All right, let's see what Shadow said. Ivy looking that good. I would not care if she had a pole or a hole. Gotcha. Also, I don't know if you've seen it, but the whole sprinkler system in a rock gym. I just put that up to building code. That was building code for Pewter City Gym. That all buildings have to have fire suppression. That's true. Sure. I'll give you that.
My first thought is that she doesn't like God of War.
No! No! Oh no!
Polar hole.
Oh man.
Alright, we got him. Whew, this is a lot of trainers here, man. I'm telling you. Alright. All right, come up. Come up. Come up. Go across. There you go. Okay. We'll see what kind of Pokemon are here, too. We're going to fight this trainer here, though, but I won't see what's in this grass. Beedrill. Level 26 Beedrill. Okay, Beedrill is fire in this game. So we'll hit him with a Bubble Beam. Yeah, Twin Needle's fucking strong now. Bubble Beam. But keep in mind, though, I know that y'all are saying, you know, oh, I wouldn't care if she had this or care if she had that. Keep in mind when the series was made and what kind of world we lived in at that time. What could be the thing that would have triggered Brock to where every time you bring up Professor Abby, he goes in the fetal position and he's so scared to talk about her. Roscoe went 32. Like I said, I think that Professor Ivy was a man. Ooh, an Almanite. Okay. We'll try it. Let's go. You would think she was a dominatrix. Maybe. I don't know. Thank you for your contribution, Mr. Realm of Roses. How are you doing today, sir? Good to have you here. Alright, so we got a Swift here. She could have been a nymphomaniac. Which, to be honest, is a terrifying concept. Wait, what if she fucked Pokemon? What if that was her kink? Tired but fine? Oh, gotcha. I'm not talking just bun. I'm talking about whip to you till you bleed, crying, begging, that kind of dominatrix. A sadistic bitch dominatrix. Maybe. Okay, that's the first thing we can think of is rough dominatrix, okay. Then there's what I said, where she could have been, you know, a woman with a penis, you know. And then there was Chris, where he said probably was into scat stuff. So, Rumble, yeah, you're catching us while we're talking about the reasons why Brock could have gotten triggered by Professor Ivy in the anime series. By the way, Rumble, name the Ammonite. Name the water snail. Named a water snail. Almighty Helix. Shelly? Alright, we're gonna name him Shelly. Shelly. And then we will check on Shelly when we get to Fuchsia City. Yeah, she. Shelly. Trainer. So, Rumble, I decided to evolve the Eevee.
And I turn into a Flareon. And it's not Electric Dragon anymore. Flareon is a ghost type now. So I have to redo some of my team now for things to work. There's a theory that Brock got her pregnant. But would he really have gotten triggered by that, though? And plus, if she got pregnant, she's a professor with a lot of fucking money. She could find his punk ass, you know? Yeah, so yeah, we have a Flareon that is a ghost type now. What if Ivy wanted Brock to pierce his tongue? Oh, man. No, she didn't get Brock pregnant. No. No. That's not a thing. He's a man. Men can't get pregnant. This ain't no Arnold Schwarzenegger, Danny, oh my god. You know what I'm talking about. Not the Prince Albert. No. No. I'm totally triggering chat, dude. This is fucking hilarious. Pokemon have... Oh, most definitely. Pokemon has some of the best conspiracies. Oh my gosh, yeah. Like, hell, still to this day, people don't know who Ash's dad is. There's like tidbits on, you know, who it could be. But there's like people thinking that it's Professor Oak. People thinking that it's Giovanni. You know, stuff like that. It's definitely not Giovanni. Big question. Did they eat Pokemon meat? Oh, yeah, they did. I remember when they were on the SSN. And they were thinking about like roast Magikarp. Oh yeah, dude. They totally eat Pokemon. Totally, dude. Totally. I wouldn't doubt it. Ash's dad is Oak. I don't know. I mean, I do think that him and Ash's mom are definitely more than just friends. I can say that for a fact. You can just tell. Hey, get out of here, bro. Like, I don't know what it is. Like, you can just tell they're not friends. I mean, more than just friends. Yeah, I kind of came around your Ash rant while I was trying to wake up. Oh, you've heard that whole rant before, though, man. You knew what I was going to fucking say. I mean, I can't say the exact word on what I think of when it comes to Ash. But the best way I can put it is that he's stupid. He just made just mistakes that I just got to be like, what the fuck, dude? Like, come on, what the fuck, dude? That's why, sadly, I like Gary Oak more. Plus, as Ash went into different regions in the Pokemon world, Gary got more mature, funnily enough. You know, Gary, in like the Kanto seasons, he was so cocky. So fucking cocky, like, smell you later, you know, for cocky. But in Johto, when he got his Umbreon, that was good. Like, that was just good. Fighting and flying. Get him. Get out of here. Yeah. Alright. We're gonna finally see what Butterfree is going to be. Alright, so we are technically done with the Caterpie for now. Alright. Gary in the Kanto arc was basically a rich little bitch that was going to get a shotgun to the face if he went to the wrong side of town. Yeah. 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 But you can't say that in the Johto one. When it came to Johto, he was maturing. He was. He was definitely maturing. Bring in Dio because he's a part. He's rock. Means it's not going to work. He has tackle, but I don't care.
Ice beam.
Yeah, Shadow loves that emote. That and the ginger love emote. He loves that one too. And the ginger dead. All the two other emotes he likes. Alright, let's see what Butterfree is going to become. Oh yeah, and that one too. Yep. Murderfly is evolving. Alright, Murderfly. We got a Butterfree! There's a Butterfree! Alright, let's see what it is. Is he gonna be useful? Okay, we got grass and electric. That's not bad. That's really not bad. Okay, so grass is weak to fire and ice. And then with the electric typing, okay, and then combining that typing with its attacks, it's good, but it's not at the same time because of that grass. That means that it wouldn't be able to fight anything that has fire attacks or ice attacks. In terms of electric. I'm just like sitting here with my eyes closed real quick with my hand on my head. That's kind of how I go into deep thought. Would that even be useful? Because I know Butterfree can be taught psychic. But would that even be useful? Not really. That would actually really hurt. That would really hurt me. Sadly enough, that would really hurt me. As much as I want to use it, that would really hurt. Alright, first few episodes forgot which was Ash saw a holo, maybe issue. Yeah, I heard about that one. That's called the Ashes in a Coma Theory. Yeah. I know about that one. I always loved the fact that he saw a Johto Pokemon in Kanto, of all places. That's hilarious. I also try and think of, like, what-if scenarios, too. So, like, for example, the world's in a loop. Okay, the loop theory. Okay, gotcha. I gotcha. Let's do Roscoe. Trying to set myself up here. Okay, let's do another for Roscoe real quick. There we go. Now we're gonna work on Stunner a little bit. Maybe he'll learn some fire moves. I would love if he did. Let's make him go this way first. Okay. I still find it funny though that Ho-Oh was in the Kanto region. Like, why the hell would a Ho-Oh be in the Kanto region? Because, you know, it's a Johto Pokemon, you know? Like, why would he be in Kanto? Migratory pattern? Migration? Possibly. But keep in mind, though, Kanto wasn't even a thing, really, when Johto, when that was the case. I mean, it was, but it wasn't. It's kind of weird. Kind of weird to really think about it. You stupid. But I do also think of what-if scenarios. Like, what if Ash caught that Pidgey when he threw that one Pokeball when he first had Ash? Or what if Ash caught that Spearow? You know? Or also, you know, what if Ash started with Squirtle? What if he started with Bulbasaur? What if he started off with Charmander? You know, like, that would have been interesting. Like, I will say, though, that Ash would have probably had the best fucking start ever if he started with Squirtle. Oh my god, dude. What if Ash wasn't dropped on his head as a kid? Oh my god, man. This is why I dig you, Shadow. I dig you. You know how to trigger my sense of humor. Sorry, buddy, but rage doesn't work on a ghost Pokemon, buddy. Nope. And he's going to keep using rage. Yeah, it would explain a few things, I'll tell you that. And Stunner grew to 29. Yay. Can I at least get Fire Spin? As much as I don't like Fire Spin, I'll even deal with Fire Spin. Dead serious, dude. I'll gladly take Fire Spin. It would be an actual attack I could use on something that's not a ghost. Ripping out to do a job. Be back soon. Alright, man. I'll be here possibly waiting for you. Alright, Swift. Thunder Wave, no. Thunder Wave. Got him. Get out of here, you little bastard. Okay. Ooh. Next.
Next one.
Champion. Love how he has a fucking cod piece. That was a fucking cod piece. Alrighty. But yeah, Rumble, sorry about the second stream reminder in the Discord. For some reason, Action decided it wanted to crash and close by itself while I was streaming. I don't know if that's happened to you, but that just happened to me today. God, I hate the fact that friggin' Quick Attack only has, like, what, 5? Yeah. That's so bad. That's an example of the randomizer being against me. Because Quick Attack's not even the strongest attack in terms of normal, but I only have 5. That's a big waste. Like, it's not even doing a lot, but, you know. It's an Eevee attack. Come on, you can do it, buddy. You can do it. You can do it. Yeah, the Bion ain't gonna do shit because he's a ghost. The Bion Whip will. Come on, man. Doesn't even do a lot. Let me use a... just one super potion. I know he's almost out of attacks, but that's fine. Just doing it so he can actually, like, survive. Because I'm still going to do the switch out thing with him. Come on. There you go. Come on. Of course you're going to do another bind attack. It's fine. Just to hit him. Just hit him. There you go. Most I've recalled action doing to me is randomly restarting to closing when it won't show my stuff and thing itself being in the red. I haven't gotten the red yet, but I think that might be because of my computer. Because of, because you know my new computer is really, really strong. Action randomly restarting. That's happened to me. My situation was it closed automatically, and when I started it back up, it said that it crashed. Yay, Stunner. Stunner's at 30. Okay, Bite's alright. I mean, it's not a... there's no such thing as dark yet, but... Bite is pretty good. I just hope it doesn't have just like 5. I'll keep him in. 25, that's good. Get him, you can do it, Stunner. Good job, buddy. Now that's a strong attack right there. Alright. Love how he looks kind of like Brock right there. Unparalyze him. Now that we have Bite, he can actually do more stuff now. Unless it's a ghost type. But Bite is really strong. Because I do need to actually do stuff with Stunner. I guess you could say having Stunner as a ghost type is pretty good. No offense. It's okay. That might hurt. I love Petal Dance's animation. It's so cool. Super potion. Give me. At least now I can actually do stuff with Stunner now. That's the interesting thing. Now I can actually... wait, I have a Poke Flute. What am I doing? What am I doing? I have a Poke Flute. I keep forgetting that this is Gen 1. Yes. Keep forgetting that it's fucking Gen 1. Now Vileplume should be confused, yes. And it hurt itself in its confusion. Perfect. Swifty. Do the Swifty-ho. There we go. Stunner getting them levels now, buddy. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're doing so good, my boy. You're doing so good. Okay. Problem is, ghost and poison. Can't do anything with that. Grass type is strong against rock. Grass. Fire. Roscoe. Because he has his different attacks. Thank God. Let's see. Thunderbolt. God damn it. Come on. Critical. Damn it, fucking stun spore. We're okay. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do something about that. He's not gonna be able to do anything if he's paralyzed. Because that's one of my things I do. Oh, that should do it. There we go. Got him. Coughing, ghost type. I just can't believe how ghost heavy this damn thing is. It's crazy. It's just crazy. Didn't want to use all of my other attacks. Lapras. Okay. Try Thunderbolt. Okay, it might be either electric. No, it's not. It's not rock. It might be ground and electric. Or electric monitor. Let me see. Okay, so it's either ground and electric as the first type. And its second type is water. Okay, no, it can't be water, so it's gotta be ground. Type of thing? Rock, maybe. Let me try some. Rock. It's fucking rock. Because ground types are strong against rock. Yeah, there we go. Damn it, he's down. It's okay. And I'm stunned. You got one swift, use it. And there we go. It wasn't going to do a lot of damage, but we got it. Welcome back, Chris. Welcome back. Okay, so Ross goes down. Luckily, we got some revives. Because I'm not done with you yet, buddy. Now we're going to do the other side. I want to make sure all these trainers are taken care of so I never have to go down this way again. So this is the funny part. This is the slow part here. And then we're going to go on the other side. And then we're going to fight those trainers because we need the experience for the other Pokemon. Uphill's always the worst thing to do. Because this is like a fucking blessing in disguise. We're actually finally able to do something with Stunner. Fine. Even though we still have normal attacks, the fact that his typing changed, it's not that bad, to be honest. Because the fact that he's ghost type now instead of electric and dragon, I'm now kind of getting revenge on these bastards. But I still need a fire type move. Two at least.
Critical.
Arcanine, a fire, some of them are normal attacks as well. Go for it. Five. Can't use roar. It's not a random encounter. I wish I had Amber. Thunder's getting some good XP right now, though. Wheezing. That's right, because it's ghost. And he's poisoned. I hate how the Pokemon get poisoned so fucking easily now. So bad. So bad, dude. Dio. Put that shit, boy. Nice big. Nice critical. Dragon Rage. Give me that 40 damage. Yeah, Dragon Rage only does 40 solid damage. Ah, wait. I need to heal him. Ah, God, I definitely need to get some fucking supplies when I get the fuchsia. Bite him. It's alright. He's almost out. That's right. His type changes. Hey, go for it, man. Go straight for it, then. Duel. It's not going to do a lot of damage. Bubble Beam.
Dio made it to 30. Nice.
I'll do,
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I have save files where I have. Okay. Flying, fighting. Iceman. Flying. Yes, me was a glitch in red and blue American version. You can get him in yellow, but it's harder to do the Mew glitch in yellow. Normal. I'm gonna go Dragon Rage with it. Plus, I don't know if you heard when I was talking before the rant and everything, when I was talking about Mew and everything, but yeah, Mew is a glitch in red and blue American version. I think Chris is doing a good job, you know, learning his pairing. I just wish he wasn't pairing with a strength build. But that's just me being a soul player. That's gonna hurt. Okay, not that bad. Okay, we got the Krabby. I'm not gonna heal. Yep. Figure as much. Another fight. I mean, you could just say you have it all except for luscious head of hair. But I like the fact that me and Chris are in the bald club. I dig it. Why do you keep poisoning my fucking Pokemon, dude? This is pissing me off. Why do you gotta keep poisoning my damn Pokemon, man? Jeez. Oh, you know I'm teasing you, man. You know I'm teasing you. Yeah, I like being an egg. Oh god, rubber buzz cuts to get there. Oh my lord, man. Infinite power. God damn. This is so kicking my ass here. Quit poisoning all my stuff. Come on, man. The Eggs Benedicts. I dig it. I dig the name. I dig it. Sounds like a bongo band, you know? A fucking bongo bander. Alright, let's go. Dio. The bald eagle is one of the mightiest birds out there, and I've got bald in the name. And they lay eggs. Perfect. Give me that 40 damage, man. Come on. Give me that 40 damage on that Persian. Yeah, there we go. Where there's a will, there's a way. I'm not talking about Will Smith. Alright. Can I get a bite? 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 I can get a bite. Nice.
bit the kitty. Deal 31.
Honestly, I'm doing really well with their leveling right now. It's really good. God damn, it's gonna fucking hurt my damn... Jeez, come on. Is it over? Yes. Yes. Yes, he is. Stone Cold Steve Austin is a bald icon. A Tango. I want to trade for my Tentacruel. If I run into one, sure. I still think my favorite promo of all time was when it was WWE versus WCW. And Stone Cold was roasting Ric Flair about him being called the Nature Boy. And he's like, I have a question. Do you like nature? Do you like boys? Don't answer that. Best fucking promo ever. Right there. Aside from, you know, like, the rare moments where Brock Lesnar likes to talk. You know, there's those moments right there. It's like, hey, Paul, say something stupid. Alright. So let's do some depositing and checking of Pokemon. Let's do it. Oh! We got a full box. Okay. We're gonna deal with that, I guess. Oh, yeah, that was a good one, too, yeah. Yeah, my little brother's favorite version of The Undertaker was American Badass Undertaker. Because he loved the whole motorcycle thing. Well, he called him Motorcycle Undertaker. But I mostly liked Motorcycle Undertaker for the Kid Rock version of his song. Alright, let's check out some Pokemon. Here we got Shelly, which is a ground type. That was the one Rumble named. Dumpy. Ghost and Poison. That's literally the same one as fucking that damn Bellsprout. No. And of course, Buzz. That's a Beedrill. You know, I just thought of something. We could have went to go get that damn Bulbasaur. I'll get it soon. I need a Pokemon that can fly at least. You know what? We're gonna go check out this grass too. Did I fix my Pokemon? Yes. Actually, let me change the boxes. Because none of those Pokemon are some that I can use. Oh, I'll always love Linkin Park. Rest in peace, Chester. I need to go in the box, too. Sum 41 was good. Agreed. I also like the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Red Hot Chili Peppers were badass, dude. Favorite song from Red Hot Chili Peppers was The Other Side. And we're going to fight these bastards too. Oh yeah, Red Hot Chili Peppers are always on another level. New metal is like every early 2000s metal band. Anybody remember Puddle of Mud? No, stream seems to be fine. Squirtle, flying type. I'm still gonna fucking bite him. The stunner needs some more levels. Damn right I remember Bubba Sparks. Fuck yeah, dude. Yeah, puddle of mud, man. And then there was corn. I still love me some Black Sabbath, though. Ozzy Osbourne's my boy. Scyther. It's a Scyther. A Scyther with double T. That's an interesting one right there. Come on. Oh my god, the double team's fucking low. No, not this. Anything but this. You know what? Swift it. Just swift it. Yeah, there we go. The answer to all double teams. Swift. Fuck off. I like how he's called a bug catcher, but he's a bird person, but yet he had a fucking Scyther. That's interesting. This is my turf, get out of here. No. It's Rods. Yeah. Alright. It's a Zubat. The reason I said that was I thought the stream might have crashed is because when you went into the Pokemon Center, it did a buffer moment, repeated that part, then stopped for a moment. But yeah, that might have been a thing with Twitch. Twitch has been acting a little weird too, of course. God, I love Twitch. Man, Stunner's getting them levels, man. Fuck yeah, dude. Oh my god, man. Stunner's doing good now. God damn, Stunner. I see no stinky pig monkeys here. Hey, you be nice to my boy. You be nice to Rods. Don't worry, Rumble. He's not talking about you. He's talking about Rods. Yeah, don't do that to Rods. Technology all around, am I right? Am I right? Indeed, man. Technology at its finest. You can't live with it. You can't live without it. I just keep biting everything now. This is like Stunner's fucking redemption now. This is his redemption arc now. All I need now is a fucking fire type move and he will be almost golden. Like Golden Freddy. Nah, Rumble ain't no pig cop from Duke Nukem. Rumble's what I would call a top tier bastard. There's no other bastard that is better or worse than Rumble. Except for Stone Cold Steve Austin. Now, Rumble don't drink, but if he was a drinker, he would top Stone Cold. He would top Stone Cold. How dare. That's a very clear sprite of Omastar. Wow. That's very good. But you know, though, I love the fact that Christmas is right around the corner, you know, and Christmas is all about family and love and the power of miracles, you know. Love me a good strong whiskey. all over here. We're just throwing whiskey on the rocks, bro. I'm actually kind of craving some of my whiskey I got right now. I recently got me some Jack Daniel's honey whiskey. That shit's fucking good, man. All right, so we've got a Beedrill at 24. Stunner went to 35, buddy. Yeah. You never know, though. You know, a nice miracle might happen to Chris on Christmas. Maybe Jaunty. Maybe even Rumble. Shadow, even. I still gotta get Shadow something for Christmas. I'm gonna think on that. Chris is like, I too like pornography, Chanty. Oh my god. You know, funny story. My first ever issue of Playboy I ever got when I was young. Rumble will probably know of this. He vaguely might remember, but I'm a jog his memory. My first ever issue of Playboy was featuring WWE, and it was the Christy Hemme one. But my favorite WWE featured Playboy was the one of Sable. That's my favorite one. That's my favorite one right there. Alright, so what we're going to do now, I know it's getting close to when I usually end around like 5. So what I'm going to do, we're going to go get some supplies from the Pokemart. And what we will do, we will end before going into the Safari Zone. Because the Safari Zone. You could actually find... I'm not even going to ask how you could find porn magazines and friggin' woods, but I can kind of put two and two together. Alright, so... First off, we got to get some hyper potions here. We're just going to need them. Chris sold them from a stall in the woods. Come get your shit here. And I need some more of these. Okay. Do I have the sell? I'm going to need to sell some stuff here. Let's see. So. I'm going to sell all the super potions. Oh my. Oh my. Alright. Get some more full heals. Okay, because I was needing those. Alright, let me see this right here real quick. Mega Drain. Can anything use Mega Drain? No, but I am going to keep that, though. Alright, so what we're going to do... We're going to move the Hyper Potions here. Keep the Revives right there. Put the Ultra Balls right here. Poke Flute... We'll put that with the bicycle. Might put the super rod away, though. We need to put the full heal somewhere, though. Let me put the full heals there. Then I'll put the ultra ball here. Bicycle. We'll go here. We'll put everything else in the box, probably. Oh, we're stuck together. It's even, Sage. Real quick, let me take myself back to the Pokemon Center real quick. Garavega, cut that down, please. Cut down this wall. Also, sooner or later, I do have to see what that damn Bulbasaur is going to be. Oh my god. Alright, let's put some stuff in this box here. Because I have to be careful about how much stuff I have on me. Because it could get real annoying. Might keep the super rod with me so I can do some fishing in the safari. Let's see. Let's put both of those in there. Let's see. Yeah, that's good. That is a really good one right there. Okay. So now I'm going to take myself all the way here. Alright, we're going to save right here, and this is how we're going to end for today. Chris, is Darth Hat Daddy 13 streaming still? I need to know. We're going to pause right here, and that's how we're going to end. So while we figure out who's live streaming right now, my next stream will be on Wednesday, which will be Soulsborne Wednesday. We're going to be continuing more Elden Ring. We're going to see how much farther we can go with the Bubble Jester. We're not going to fight Malekith yet. We're going to try and get ourselves to Melania and everything, because I want to try her out. And then, of course, sooner or later, we'll go and fight Moog, because I want to try that out with him and stuff, too. And then Friday will be Retro Friday. We're going to be continuing more of our minor cheats run of Digimon World 1. We're going to be doing that. So if any of that tickles your fancy, you know, give the channel a follow. Anything like that, keep your notifications on. Also, when it comes to being in the Discord, if you are a subscriber of any kind, basically, you'll know of certain things I'm working on. Plus, I'm sorry if my Discord's usually very, very silent and everything. You know, it just happens. I do have one minor request. Chris, not on stream, but on Discord, can you send a link to Jonty to join the Discord server? I would really appreciate that. Because I feel like Jonty has become a regular enough to where I could bring him into the Discord and, you know, he can hang out there whenever he wants to. So yeah, if you could do that for me after stream, I'd appreciate that. But yeah, we're going to try and raid Darth Hat Daddy 13. Can I get exclamation point raid 1 and exclamation point raid 2 in chat, please? Thank you very much. I'm going to go ahead and get the raid situated here. Okay. Let's see, Darth Hat Daddy 13. Come on, type right. There you go. There we go. Yeah, type good. I'm getting tired. Can I get the raid one message as well, please, for the subscribers? I'd appreciate that, please. There we go. Thank you, Rumby. Thank you, sir. Thank you. All right, copy. All right, so let's get this raid situated here. Here we go. All right, so, yeah, please go and get your raid message ready. If you are a subscriber to the channel, do a copy-paste of the Raid 1 message. If you are not a subscriber, do a copy-paste of the Raid 2 message. We're going to go raid my big brother and my big sister, Darth Hat Daddy 13, and 9 times out of 10, Twiggy Fett will be there as well. So get your raid messages ready. I will see you guys on Wednesday, 1 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, for more Elden Ring with the Bubble Jester. So big shout out to all my mods, and also big shout out to Mr. Rumble Roses for popping on in. I appreciate you coming in as always, my dude. So yeah, as always, everyone, thank you so much for watching. I am your friendly neighborhood game machine, and this was Pokemon Yellow Twin Eevee's Randomizer. And until I see everyone in the next video or live stream, peace out. Happy gaming, my friends. And please stay safe out there. And please stay warm. Please stay warm.